Hi everyone, this is Lisa from Canine Clips, and this is Romeo. And Romeo has come to me for the full groom today. We're going to do that on video. And he's got quite a little bit of more of a unique cut in that he has a mullet. So you can kind of see it hanging down there on the side. But once we get him all trimmed up, it's pretty funny because business in the front and party in the back. So. And I'll probably do another video on that as well, because it is pretty cool. His owner showed me a photo of him riding on the boat, and his mullet's just a-flying in the wind there. So it looks pretty darn cute. So something unique. He's the only guy that that I groom that has a mullet. So I will do a special video on that as well after this groom. Get that documented, you know, for scientific reasons. We need to have the mullet. But he's a good boy. He's a Morkie, so a Maltese crossed with a Yorkie. Really nice temperament, as you can see. Just a good boy. So we do the number body in the number 5, and then just scissor cut around the head there to get the mullet growing there. And so this will be his third time with me growing out the mullet. And just before he came to me, they had already started growing it out. So right now it's actually at a really good length, so it'll look pretty cool after today's grooming. See the mullet here. Has a little bit of mats in it. Blowing in the wind, I'm assuming. We'll be able to get that out. Okay, so I'm just going to true up the face. Make sure we leave that mullet there. That's actually growing from the back of the head. And it hangs all the way down. So under here, it's all nice and clean. But just the back of the head has that hair coming back and growing down. So then it kind of hangs down near his sides there. Starting a new trend. And lucky me, I get to put it on YouTube, so. Okay, buddy. Just gonna lower him a little bit so I can see the top of the head when I'm doing a little better. I want to make sure I don't trim the mullet. Okay. Keep it separate. You can see right at the back of the head there is when it kind of grows out there. And then we'll use the clippers here to give them that nice mullet look. Okay, the rest I'm going to use clippers for that area. So now I'm going to move on to the feet. Actually, since I'm here, I'll also check out his ears. And we'll trim those. Just gonna trim this top of the ear. Okay. There we go. I'll do the other side. Sorry, use that up. Okay, turn, buddy. See, it goes a little bit with the mullet, so I don't want to keep those separate there. Okay, I'm just gonna pluck out the hair and the ears. He's got a bit of hair in there. So his ears are starting to get a little bit pink. So this should help once I get all this hair out, then the wax doesn't have anything to stick to, which makes the hair heavy and grows back into the ear canal. So once I get all this out, it'll give the ear a little bit more airflow as well, so that when he does shake his head and scratch his ears, he's able to get better airflow in there and dry out anything of the wax. And it should hopefully just fall out, which will give him much more comfort. It's good to keep those ears clean. Alright, so there's the one. You can see there's quite a bit of hair in there. So we'll get the other ear done. Okay. Other side, but one more. There we go. This ear's about the same, a little bit pink. Let's see if I can get you guys to see it here. See what I'm looking at? So as long as the hair is in the ear canal, it does come out quite easily, as you can see. It will irritate some dogs more than others. It all depends on how long it's been sitting in there, if their ears are a little sore too. But it does come out quite easily, as long as it's inside that ear canal. Outside, it'll be very tough to pull, which would hurt, of course. So you want to make sure that's why I always scissor cut this nice and short, so that making sure I don't accidentally pluck the outer ear hair. There, once that's all out, he'll feel a lot better. And there we go, we got a lot in there too. That's yours. All right, so there we go. His ears are good. Now I'll get started on the feet. A little bit of tickle. So funny. You're so funny, boy. Sometimes when you touch your scissors in there, they give you a little jolt like that. There are some dogs that when you're using the clipper blades on here, they're twisting and a-turning because they're like a little bit ticklish. I haven't had one on film yet, but they're pretty cute. Cute to watch. It's a little more difficult to groom them because they're squirming a little bit, but it's still funny because they're just ticklish. Hey, no. Okay. Here we go. 1 foot that. You can see he's got a bit of fur under there. Sometimes when the pads are a little soft, they're a little bit more sensitive. But as soon as you get any resistance, it's good to, you know, stop and check too. So that's what I did. So there is no cut. Yes, the ticklish. So he does give me a good swat here. And he's quick. Come on. These scissors are just about ready to go to get sharpened. You can see sometimes they have a little bit of a miss in them, so I'll make the motion, but they won't do a good cut, so. But of course, I like to use them as long as I can. Before I pull out the other pair and send these off to get sharpened. It's okay, buddy. Hey, Romeo. Hey. Hey, buddy. Hey, 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 hey. Okay, just the dew claw. There you go. All right, half done the feet. So if this is your first time watching me, thanks for joining. If you've been watching me for a long time, thank you as well. I appreciate the time to take to watch. If you have a chance, please subscribe. I really like that. I'm trying to build up my channel as fast as I can, so I can keep doing this. I'm really having a lot of fun, but I appreciate all the little tips everyone's given me as well. And I'm trying to incorporate to make your video experience better as well, and get you what you need to do what you want to do. So thanks for your support, and like I said, if you could please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already, that would really help me out. It's okay. Come on, buddy. He wants to go as far as he can. There you go. There, good boy. All right. All right, now we're just on the last foot. All right, so then after this, I'm just gonna comb out his tail and then he'll be ready for the tub. Hey. No, I don't like him twisting like that. One more. Yay, good boy. Okay, good boy. Good to get that hair out. It's a little harder to comb out when it's wet. Alright, there we go. Okay, and now we are going to head off to the tub. Okay, buddy, your turn. Okay, buddy. Now, time for the dry. Oh, we'll get your head. Give you those puppy dog eyes. Okay. Okay, now we are ready to blow dry. Okay, good boy. Okay. Now for the blow dryer. The number five blade, so you can kind of see where the mullet is here. So when owner dropped off, we're gonna extend the mullet just a little bit to include some of this darker color as well. So I'm just gonna kind of comb it backwards and hopefully we'll be able to get it to stay so that we have a little line of the darker color too. That'll grow out eventually. All right. Okay, so we got that separated. Well, hopefully he won't shake again. And nest it all in there. All right, so we got the number 5 ready. I'm just gonna get started here. Gonna get that line done first. Just to make sure I get it. Just in case he shakes. There we go. Yeah, now we have our new mullet. A little bit thicker. So his fur is still a little bit damp. So that helps keep the clippers a little bit cooler for me. But it is important to check them regularly. I find the longer the clippers, the blade, the longer the clipper blade, the less they get hot. So the shorter they are, the more often I check. So this, it won't get warm for quite a while because the fur is damp. But I do like to check it, so I'll just kind of put it on my hand or on my wrist just to check. Especially if I'm going in any sensitive areas that the skin is a little more sensitive. I'll kind of check it before then as well, but it does stay quite cool for quite a while. The number 10s I do check quite often because you're right close to the skin of the dog. You want to make sure you don't burn that skin. So I'm gonna make sure. Let's see. Okay, I just want to make sure it's the same on both sides. So I'm gonna go from the bottom of the ear. There we go. Okay. Get this side. Blades are still good. Again, it does help that he is damp. When I give him his second blow dry, then his fur won't be as damp as more, so, but then I'll just be cleaning him up. I do have a playlist created, which this cut, well, the final cut, I won't put the full groom in there, but the cut for I have one for Mohawk, and I have one for the mutton chops, and then I'll have one for this guy too, so anything unique I kind of put in there. Pretty good, but I might as well change it out to make sure. I don't want to chance it. I'm actually going to switch to number 7 as well for under here. This area has a little bit of mat, so that's why I'm going to go a little shorter, because it is prone to matting. And of course stuff sticking to it, so we'll clean that all up. But then it blends nicely. And you just go one length lower. Do his armpit here as well in the number 7. Maybe a few little mats in there. Hey, nice to see you, buddy. You can really see it coming along here, but I am going to have to blow dry it to to get all the moisture out so I can give it a nice comb. I kind of want to see if there's any mats in it first. Okay, so I'm going to give another quick blow dry without his muffs on so that I can get the head a little bit better dry. Just going to clean off the table. Good look at what we're doing. So I'm gonna first start with the clippers at the number 5 again. Well, this is all laying up nice. So this final clipping just cleans up anything that I may have missed. Kind of lifts up all the fur, so helps me catch anything, and it gives a nice even cut at the end. And again, the fur isn't completely dry at this stage, but it's got a little bit of dampness to it, but it's predominantly dry. Buddy. Just about done, buddy. Just gonna add some clipper oil. As I can hear it starting to. There we go. Sometimes the blades will make a different noise. You just know it just needs a little bit more lubrication there. Especially when you're grooming on a damp dog, which I do all the time. And if they're lubricated properly, then they won't get as hot this fast either. I'd miss this leg completely. It's always good to go back a second time. That's so funny. Too focused on the mullet. Getting distracted. Okay. Okay, buddy, let's see what we got here. So, let's see what the head just looks like without the mullet. Make sure it's all nice and clean. Because we want a nice, clean business front. Okay, I'm going to do a little combing under there, so I got a little bit of a mat. So let's clean that up first. Just a little one. Okay. There we go. So there is our true mullet form. Okay, so I just want to get a good view of the mullet. And I'm going to take another short clip video just of it as well. So as you can see, it's nice and long here at the back of the head. Then it hangs down where it gets that nice mullet look as well with the short ears. And so then when he's running or whatever, it flows nicely in the wind there for him. So there we go. So there is our mullet. So I just wanted to give you a quick little view of that. So thanks for taking the time to watch, and I will do another quick little short video on that this as well, because it's quite unique having a mullet. And appreciate you taking the time to watch, and please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate that, and I hope you have a great day. Take care, and we'll see you soon.